In the last video, we produced the outline of Switzerland as polygon, and in this video, I would like to use this to cut out from an overarching layer of C14 dates those C14 dates that are within Switzerland. To do that, at first, I will add my layer of C14 dates, so I get to go to layer, add layer, and the limited text layer, because it's a CSV file. And I have to select this CSV file, so here it's the C14 data file. And this is a bit different from what we had before, because before we had the X and the Y coordinates in the beginning somewhere, and they were named X and Y. But here we have them at the end, and they're called lat and long. So this is latitude and longitude. Longitude translates to the X coordinate, and latitude translates to the Y coordinate. And we also have to select the CRS. And since it's latitude longitude, it's this WGS84 EPSG 4326, the standard coordinate system that you're probably most used to. So you have to make sure that this is selected and the right X and Y coordinates are selected. And that's all. With that, we can add our C14 dates. And now you can see it currently doesn't cover the whole of Europe, but it goes beyond Switzerland. And we would like, for probably performance reasons, just to work with the C14 dates within Switzerland. So we have to extract those dates in relation to this polygon. To do so, we need to start now the toolbox, because usually we worked until now with this menu items, but some of the functions are not visible from the menu as such. So additional functionalities can be achieved by selecting this toolbox here. And now we can see here some categories, and all what you can do, most of the analytical stuff that you can do with the menu is also in here, but also additional functionalities. And if I just open up here some, you can see that there's a lot more. Best is you know where to search, or you could also use this search bar up here, and I can start typing in English or German. So I want to extract. You can see that the list is narrowing down. And our selection is extract by position. So that's what we would like to do now. So I click this. And if you don't know what kind of tool you could use, you have to look up in the QGIS manual and search for therefore the functionality that might be appropriate for your kind of analysis. So I click extract by position, and then I get here a dialog that asks me extract objects from, and I want to extract those objects from the C14 dates, and what kind of the geometric combination should be used. So here cuts is fine in this case, and I want to have to select which kind of objects serve as comparison. So in this case, it's the union, the dissolved union of the borders of Switzerland. So I use this layer here. And again, I would like to have a temporary layer, and I want to have that visible after success. So I click on start. Here we see something red, so the input layer doesn't have a spatial index. This can make the performance worse, but still the output is finished, so we don't have an error here. We can close that down. And now you can see we have a new layer here with these brown points. If I remove the original ones, you can see now we have those files or those points extracted that are within the border of Switzerland here. Now I can start doing stuff with that. At first I could, for example, export these, because we're still working with these temporary layers. You can see that by this icon here. Now I can save this to make it permanent or export it. It actually is the same. So making this permanent, I save that as SV shapefile. I select the location, and for me now I put that to download, and I name that 14C in Switzerland.shape. Click on save and OK, and now this layer is saved. And from now on we can work with some analytical processing. We can start from here with our reduced layer. How we can do that, we will see in the next video.